Hello, Hofstra fans, and welcome to this week's edition of the WB Mason Coaches Report. My name is Rachel Vogel, and today I am joined once again by the head softball coach of the Hofstra Pride, Jay Miller. Coach, how are you today?
Well, I guess doing as well as can be expected.
Yes, Coach. Unfortunately, a little bit of unexpected news coming in this morning with Hofstra's series against Towson. Postponed due to a COVID result within the Towson program. But Coach, this is what the season has been like, not just for Hofstra, but for everybody around. So before we dive into what's possibly up next for the Pride, let's talk a little bit about how the Pride have been performing over the last couple weeks. I know last weekend, a little bit of a tough series against Delaware, but I guess you could say that the Hofstra softball team was relentless all weekend long, never really gave up. And like I said, unfortunately fell on the 2-1 end of a series. But Coach, just talk about your team this past weekend against Delaware and what you may have seen from the Pride.
Well, I think I was disappointed in our pitching this weekend against Delaware. I thought we scored plenty of runs. I thought we had an opportunity to win some games. I think that the sort of the bright spot was our kids coming in off the bench. I thought we did a great job in terms of, Maddie McKivitt, Alexis Goki, Sam Ward, Alex Corbin, all did a great job coming off the bench and making some things happen for us offensively. So that was a great sign, I thought, and really something that we've been lacking from our ball club, and something that we're going to need going into the sort of the stretch run here at the end. So hopefully that's something that can continue, and we can keep getting that kind of production off our bench.
We'll dive into some of those players a little bit more, but Coach, you found yourself in some pretty big holes this weekend against Delaware. It can be very easy for some of your players to put their heads down and call it quits, but you did not see that on the final, the rubber match. When in the bottom of the seventh inning, you put up 5 runs, and I'm sure Delaware really was not expecting that and was really looking to close it out, but you turned around and gave them a little bit of trouble, caused a pitching change late. Just talk about the never say die mentality of your team and how that showed this weekend.
Well, I think that's a good point. I think that, we've got a group of players on our ball club that one, have some pride and what they're doing and how they're performing. And two, they don't quit. They don't give up. They keep fighting. They keep battling. And good things happen when you do that. So I thought that was a good sign from our team and something that's definitely needed. The sad thing is we're digging ourselves too much of a hole at the beginning to climb out of. So we need to do a better job there, both on the mound and defensively too. We had some letdowns that cost us some runs that normally we haven't been having.
And you mentioned some players who really stepped up this past weekend, the pinch hitter specifically, as you mentioned, Maddie McKevitt with her first career home run, a grand slam, as I mentioned, in the bottom of the seventh inning. And Sam Ward, a couple big 2 RBI hits. Alexis Goki, same thing. And Coach, if you have watched Hofstra softball over this season, and really since your arrival, you may notice that you'll make some pinch hitting decisions, not really when teams expect it. It doesn't matter if it's the first inning, second inning, or the bottom of the seventh. So just talk about your confidence in some of your players and just their awareness to be ready and on their toes at all times.
Well, I think that's your role as everybody has roles on the team. Some roles are starters, some are backups, some are, pinch runners and pinch hitters and things like that. And one, you need to embrace your role, whatever it might be. Two, you need to be ready to perform whenever your role is called upon. And I think that, our kids know that. And they know it's the situation might come up in the first inning or the last inning or any of the middle innings. So they're ready to go and ready to perform when we need some help.
And now looking ahead, unfortunately, you don't really know what's next for your team at the moment. Could be the single game next week against Seton Hall, could be the next CAA series, and maybe you pick up a game here and there leading up to that. But how important is it for you to address your team to stay focused during this time?
Well, they know that. They know where we're at. They know where we stand, you know, in the conference. They know what we need to do. You know, obviously they were looking forward to Towson this weekend here at home. You know, it's unfortunate we lose those games. And, you know, and maybe we can find some replacements. Who knows? So, but as of right now, our next game is next Wednesday, and we prepare for that. And if that changes, then we'll adjust and adapt.
Adjust and adapt seems to be the theme of the last 18 or so months. But Coach, as of now, Pride is back in action Wednesday against Seton Hall. And Coach, wish you the best of luck for whatever is next on the docket for Hofstra softball. All we know is we're ready to play, and give us a give us a day and a time, and we'll all be there. And
that
Coach,
sounds right.
Thank you very much for taking the time to speak with me today. And that was the WB Basin Coaches Report with head softball coach Jay Miller on GoHofstra.com.
Thanks, Rachel.